when you have someone as good as Judy in the movie, you should use her. I mean, that seemed to me to be, to be essential. She's there, and she's a wonderful, wonderful actress, and let's get the best out of her. Make her work a bit for her money.
Both Jamie and Sam have always been really supportive of me and of my work, and having them around helped a great deal. But, you know, I would never have been able to do the German in the film without Christoph Waltz's help. You know, he's been such an amazing friend and collaborator in that area. And also Quentin and Leo. I mean, I think about that scene at the dinner table where Leo and I had to do some very physically challenging interactions. And every time Quentin would say cut, he and Leo would come running to me. Are you okay? Are you okay? Can we go again? Do we need to do it differently? Take care of yourself. So, you know, I think as a cast, we all really, and we all took care of each other with Quentin as our fearless leader.
I didn't know Benedict before we started working together, and spoke to him a little bit, and clearly he was an amazingly astute, articulate gentleman, but it was really wonderful working with him, because immediately when he came on set, it was like, and they all got to know each other beforehand a little bit, but it was immediately clear that, like, it was on, and, like, everyone just was on their A game at all times. Like, no one was slacking, because there was something about Benedict's, you know, focus and his presence that really just helped challenge everyone to do the best possible job. It was awesome.
It was like going to Bill's house and there was a party going on. It was just his big arm span, and he's a, you know, big guy, and he knew everybody, appreciated what everybody did, everybody's names, and he carried around huge speakers at all times. So between shots, when everyone's working hard, the sparks are up ladders, and he'd press play and some random tunes would come out, and he's winking and nodding, and you could see people starting to work like that. He was just really fun.
I care about Jesse deeply, and I cared about him as soon as I met him, because he just looks so fragile and vulnerable, and as soon as you get to know him a little bit, you admire him greatly in his brilliance, his brilliance of mind and of spirit and generosity and of both of those things, and his way of seeing the world. He's very unique and also incredibly open and curious. So, you know, I mean, I could write a thesis on why everyone should be in love with Jesse Eisenberg. I really, really honestly could.
Getting to know an actor is very important to me. I mean, you know, I'm not interested in actors, I'm more interested in artists. And getting to know me, getting to know them, and just having an idea of trust, and they knowing that I would go as far as they would, and to have an environment where they could experiment, and fail and make a fool of themselves, and not be embarrassed to explore.
Matthew is kind of stays unrelentingly true to his vision, sometimes to the point where, you know, you're pulling your hair out, because he'll walk onto a set or a room, and if it's not the way he really pictured it, he can't shoot it, you know, and it's back to square one, and you know, that can be for an actor sometimes can be a little exhausting, but you know, I always try to remember that the process of making the film doesn't really matter, because no one's going to see the process. What they're going to see is the film, and that's what you have to hope works out.
He's supremely confident, you know. He's been doing this for a while, and he's sort of developed his own way of filming and working. And there's, you know, I think he very much serves the story, as opposed to, like, this is David Cronenberg. You know, he was explaining that in the press conference. You know, and you know, not putting a style on a story, you know, you sort of let the story dictate to you how you film it, and but in terms of working with him, he's very precise, and he's editing as he films. So you do, you know, a section, cut, move on to the next section for whatever it is, the mid, close shot, you know, whatever, and so you move very fast, and you know, there's an easiness about him on set. Again, he's got a crew that he works with that he's familiar with, so it's it's just a very easy experience, as opposed to maybe some people think it's dark and perverse, but he's actually the opposite, light and sort of encouraging.
David Fincher directing this movie intuitively is not a logical marriage of director and material. David is most known for being peerless as a visual director, and I write people talking in rooms. But David came in, he absolutely embraced the idea that this was going to be a story told with language, but he did bring his distinctive visual style to it. He got remarkable performances out of a very young cast. And then in editing and scoring the movie and doing everything that you do in post-production, made a film, I think, much better than the sum of its parts.
I've never worked with anyone whose shoulders so much of the movie really just rests. He makes it look very easy, but it's really not. I mean, 130 days of just relentless 5 o'clock starts and the physical pressure of the role. I said to him, look, you know, I know that there's that, I'm going to do this with a stunt guy because it's going 50 miles an hour on top of a train, fist fight over a 500-foot drop, and you've only got one cable attaching you. And he said, no, let me have a go. And he said, well, all right, we'll go slowly to begin with. You know, he went 20 miles an hour. Go a bit faster, 30 miles an hour. And, you know, before you know it, half an hour later, he's traveling at 50 miles an hour. And, you know, and my heart was genuinely in my mouth. I kept saying, you don't have to do this. But what happens when you do do it, and you're downhill, is it lifts the whole crew. And it's so exciting, you know, and there's a real sense that there's a leader amongst the cast and that he cares. If he cares enough to do this, you know, woe betide anyone who doesn't care about their job, you know, and on the set. And I think that that's a real example, and it makes an enormous difference to the making of the film.
Inevitably, you come to blows a couple of times. You have creative arguments. Nick and I very rarely argue in real life because, you know, we're just mates. We have had big barneys over the years, but they're always resolved very quickly. And we did have a few rows over Paul because it's hard in the creative process to be turned down. So if you get, say, three ideas poo-pooed in a row, it starts to feel a bit personal and your hackles go up. So you say, what about this? No. What about this? No. What about that? No. And then it's like, what? You just don't want me to be in it. And then, so I'm going to say this, and it has to go in. And then you start realizing you're playing mind games with each other, which is dangerous.
The principal difference working with Michael is not being in control and being comfortable with not being in control and not quite knowing what's going to come out at the end and that being okay. And what that means is you get interesting stuff.
I know that Quentin's film sets are very different from everybody else's in terms of the level of fun that you're going to have. Some people tend to take themselves really seriously because they're making a film. Quentin, you're making a movie. You're there to, you know, kind of play a big kid's game. Everybody's playing make-believe. The things that are serious just happen to be serious. The things that are funny just happen to be funny. There's no emphasis to say, okay, we got to make this funny or we got to make this serious or you got to, you know, take this seriously. No, you just kind of do it.
There is an environmental quality to the way Paul works. A lot of films are shot in literally sequences or segments of like a master and then coverage. Paul, as a documentarian that he had been, and certainly based on the films that I've seen him make, even the Bourne movies, are all really all about capturing the environment. We shot these scenes from beginning to end, over and over again.
Sam Rockwell is one of the most kind of imaginative actors I've worked with. I mean, he's, you know, some people would call it in a pejorative way tricksy, but it's not. It's really he's really creative and he's really imaginative and he's really in the moment and he's coming up with new stuff every single take and every single line reading. So it's amazing to play off that and be close to that. And Christopher Walken is just Christopher Walken, and you know, he's one of those people you can just actually say that. He's so, you know, and he's not, he's weird and all that. He's really not. I mean, he's just remarkably unlike anyone else. He's just more unlike anyone else than anyone else I've ever met in my life.